Hey guys, what's up? Flatback Effects here, back with another tutorial, and today we're going to be making this. So stick around, you're watching Flatback Effects. Alright, so let's jump straight in. So in this tutorial, we're going to be taking a look at how to create the Netflix style logo. Now there's already a bunch of logo tutorials out there for this exact same thing, but a lot of those involve using 3D programs or different plugins. So I thought I'd do one using After Effects with no plugins needed. Now in order to do this inside of After Effects, we're going to be using ray trace rendering to create the 3D elements we need. Now just a quick heads up, for those of you that have used ray trace rendering before, you know how taxing it can be on your system. Now to minimize the amount of time for the render of this project, we're going to build as much as we can without turning on the ray trace rendering, and then when we're ready we'll turn on ray trace rendering at the end and we can export our project. Alright, so with that, let's get started. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is right click and create a new composition, and I'm going to make sure that's set to HDTV 1080 25 1920 by 1080 and then hit OK. Alright, now the very first thing we want to do is right click on our composition and we're going to open up our composition settings. Now your layout may be different depending on the version of After Effects you have, but there'll be a section that talks about 3D rendering. Now if you go to that section, under the renderer, we want to make sure that it's set to the classic 3D and then hit OK. Alright, next we're going to right click and we're going to create a solid and we're going to change the color to white. Alright, next we're going to make this 3D. Then we're going to right click and we're going to create another solid and I want to change this one to be black. Next I'm going to come up here to my ellipse tool and I'm just going to simply draw a rough sort of mask around like this. Now I'm going to open up the mask settings and I'm going to create a bit of a feather on this. I'm also going to click this to make it inverted. And then I'm going to navigate down to my transform options, down to opacity, and just turn this down to about 26. Now we can go to our mask expansion and just roughly adjust this to either shrink it or make it larger. So something about there looks good, just so we get a little bit of a darkened sort of edge to our background. All right, next we're going to right click and we're going to create a new text layer. And I'm going to type out my text, so this can be whatever you want it to be. Now this is the exact font I'm using up here, but again you can set this to whatever you want. I've also turned on the boldness, and these are the settings if you want to match exactly what I've got. Otherwise you can use your own font, whatever you want. Okay, next I'm going to grab my layer, and I'm going to come up to edit and then down to duplicate. Now I'm going to select that text, and I'm going to make it all white. Next, I just want to delete everything except my first letter. Okay, then I'm going to grab my letter and I'm going to come up to edit and then down to duplicate. And I'm going to reposition this over my next letter and I'm going to change this to an E or whatever letter you've got next. And then I'm going to duplicate this again and just simply just keep repeating the process until they line up over the top. Okay, now I'm going to grab all of my letters and I'm going to make them 3D. So I'm going to turn on the 3D and I'm going to grab my first letter and I'm going to hit P on the keyboard to bring up the position and create a keyframe. Then I'm going to go across about a quarter of a second and create another keyframe. Then I'm going to go to the 1 second mark and create another keyframe. Okay, next I'm going to go to my middle keyframe and I'm going to go to the very last value of my position and I'm going to change this to be negative 100. I'm also going to right click and I'm going to make this easy ease. Now I'm also going to move these closer together just to speed up this overall animation. Next I'm going to open up the position keyframe for my other layers and I'm going to create keyframes for the beginning. I'm going to go in line with my next keyframe. I'm going to create another keyframe and then again with my last keyframe. Then I'm going to select all those middle keyframes and I'm going to right click and make them easy ease. Now I have to select each keyframe and make these all negative 100. Okay, next I'm going to grab all my layers and I'm just going to slightly move them over because I want them to come in at about half a second. Now I'm going to go to the middle of my keyframes and I'm going to grab my top layer or my very last letter and I'm going to drag the start so it lines up with my last one. Now all these layers in between, we just have to stagger evenly. So I just move these all over so that they stagger and align like this. Then with my last keyframe lined up on my first letter, I move all of these keyframes to match. So they should all line up at the end. So that's what we should have there. Then I can grab my red layer and I'm going to drag this on top. And I'm going to shift this over so that it comes in just before my last keyframe. Then I'm going to select all of my layers and I'm going to come up to edit and then down to split layer. And they will automatically be highlighted. And then all I need to do is just hit delete on my keyboard. So this is what we should end up with here. Okay, next we're going to come down and grab our background layer. I'm going to also duplicate this. And I'm going to shift this so it's above my black layer. Then I'm going to rename this to be shadow. And I'm going to navigate down to the material options. And where it says accept shadows, I'm going to click this so it appears as only. And then where it says accept lights, I'm going to select off. Then I'm going to turn my opacity down to 31%. All right, next I'm going to right click and I'm going to create a new light. Now this light, I'm going to make sure it's set to spot and you can leave all these by their default. All right, so once you've added the light, yours won't look like this. So you need to actually position your light so that it's off the screen and pointing in the right direction. Now you can do this manually or you could just enter these values in. So if you go down to your transform and enter this exact point of interest for each of the three, and then this exact position for each of the three, yours should start to look more like this. Now I'll put those values in the description below so you can simply copy and paste those in. Next, if we navigate down to the light options, where it says intensity, if you drag this up, you'll start to see the background lightens. So for this one, I'm going to drag it to about there. Okay, next I want to make sure my color is set to white. My cone angle is set to 96. My cone feather is 0. I've put cast shadows as on. And shadow darkness is set to 200%. Now at the moment it doesn't look like much. So we've got a few more things we need to do. Now if we navigate down to our first letter, we're going to go down to the material options. And I'm going to change a few settings here. So I'm going to make sure that cast shadows is set to on. And where it says accept shadows, I'm going to turn that off. And also make sure accept lights is off as well. Now all you need to do is just simply repeat this process for your other letters. So I'm going to select them all here. I'm going to navigate down to material options. And then I'm going to make sure that those settings match again. So cast shadows is on, accept shadows is off. And accept lights is off as well. Now, if we just play through this, this is what we should have now. Now, if we grab our top layer, our red Netflix, and hit S on the keyboard, I'm going to create a scale. So I'm going to create a scale for when it first appears, and then go along on the timeline however long I want, and then just hit a scale to about 93. Okay, so this is what we should have now. Now, next we need to turn on ray trace rendering. So before you do this, I recommend just dropping this down to quarter. Then I recommend saving your project at this point because you don't know exactly how it's going to react. So once you're ready, I'd right click, go to your composition settings, and under 3D render, you have these three options. Now, if you have Cinema 4D installed, you can use the Cinema 4D render engine, which I recommend. Otherwise, you can use the Ray Trace 3D. Now in this case, I'm going to use the Ray Trace 3D, but if you have Cinema 4D, I recommend using that because it will run a lot smoother. And then once you've done that, just hit OK. Now your computer will look as if it's frozen at this point, but it does take a while to load. But this point is a real test to see how long it actually takes to render a frame. Okay, so once you've turned that on, it should look like this. Now if yours doesn't, What you simply need to do is navigate down to each letter and find the geometry options. Now under here, you've got an extrusion depth. So you can actually adjust this, and that's basically adding a three-dimensional part onto the back of the letter. So the larger that number, the more it's extruding out the back. So generally the default of 100 is fine, but keep in mind the further you move the letter off the screen, the more you're going to increase this number. Now at this point on quarter resolution, I just recommend scrubbing through just to make sure that everything's there. Once you feel confident that everything looks the way it should, you can increase your resolution and then you can start your RAM preview. So you just hit spacebar on the computer and that'll start your RAM preview. Now this render is going to take a while, so I'm going to skip ahead to one that I've actually prepared earlier. All right, so I've rendered that little part there, and I've just noticed a little problem here. So just towards the end, this layer comes in slightly too early. So all I need to do is just shift this over, just to adjust, and then I can begin my render again. So I've skipped ahead in the render, and this is what it should look like now. All right, so one other thing to note, if this animation is too fast, or you want to add more of a delay between the first letter and the last letter, all you need to do is just go back into your properties again, and then just shift these around. So if you want to make it slower, you can drag these further apart. Or if you want to make it faster, you can drag them closer together. And that'll control your overall timing for your project. So that's pretty much the effect. So if you want to go and change your text, all you need to do is I'd recommend turning off the render engine back to the classic 3D, then go through and change all your text again, and then at the very end, turn your render engine back on, and then export your project. So there you go, guys. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you've learned something. And remember, Flatpak Effects is the Flatpak anyone can build.